Hello friends, and welcome to another tutorial on Geeks for Geeks. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss few of the many applications that depth-first search has. First, let us have a quick overview of what depth-first search is. The basic idea behind this traversal is that given a graph, we have to go forward depth-wise while there is any such possibility. If not, then we have to backtrack. Let's assume this is the graph and we have to do depth-first traversal in this. One of the way for this can be to start from this vertex A, go to its unvisited neighbor B, then D, then E, F, and finally C. For a detailed explanation, you can check out our explanatory video that we have covered earlier. Now let's look at few of the applications that can be done using depth-first search. We have listed few of them and will try to give you a basic idea about each one of them. The first one is cycle detection. The next is topological sorting. We then see how to find strongly connected component. The next is pathfinding between given two vertex. We then see how to find if a given graph is bipartite or not. In the last, we look at how to solve general puzzle problem using depth-first search. We begin with the first application, which is to detect if a given graph consists of a cycle or not. We have a sample graph here and it also contains a cycle. Now, the basic algorithm is to see that for every visited vertex V, if there is an adjacent U such that U is already visited and U is not parent of V, then we say we have a cycle. Now here parent simply refers to the node from which we are just coming from. Let's run depth-first search for this graph. We start with vertex A and visit it. Then we move to the adjacent unvisited node B and we visit it. Now from C we visit it and also see that there is no unvisited node left. Also we notice that we have a visited node A which is not parent of C. Therefore we can say that this graph has a cycle and can terminate our depth first search. The next application is topological sort. This is one of the important applications generally used for job scheduling. We first understand what topological sort is. Topological sort is for directed acyclic graphs only. It is linear ordering of vertices such that if a graph has an edge u, v, then U should appear before V in ordering. We see this through an example graph. If we start ordering from vertex A, then next to follow should be either B or C. Then we can have D and then E. We can look to it as a prerequisite sort of ordering, that is, job A must be done before doing job B or job C. Similarly, both job B and C should be finished before we can start job D and so on. For the given graph, if we start from vertex A, we can have two possible ordering as written here. Now let's look at how to do topological sorting using depth-first traversal. We simply modify our DFS to have an extra temporary stack. We start with vertex A, visit it, move to vertex B, visit it, then visit D, then visit E. Now from E, we don't have any go, so we backtrack to D and also push the vertex in our temporary stack. D also don't have any adjacent unvisited node, so we push D into stack. Similarly, we push B and then backtrack to A. A has an adjacent unvisited neighbor, which is C, so we visit it. Now from C, we again have no way to go. So we push C into our temporary stack. We backtrack to A. Now A has both the neighbor visited, so we have no left path. We therefore push A into our temporary stack, and with this the DFS terminate. Now for final topological ordering, all we have to do is to print the content of the stack. The final answer is A, C, B, D and E. We move on to another application of depth first traversal, which is to find strongly connected component or SCC. SCC refers to finding the maximum subgraph in a given graph such that there is a path from all pairs of vertices. We see SCC with the help of an example. In this graph, we have three strongly connected components. See how in the subgraph, we can go from each node to rest others. We can go from 0 to 2 or from 0 to 1 via 2. This strongly connected component can be found through two famous algorithms. The first is Kosaraju's algorithm, where we run depth first twice, and the other is Tarjan's, where we can get SCC in a single pass. The next application is the pathfinding, wherein we have to find a path between two given vertices. The algorithm will be pretty simple. We start our depth first search from the source node. To keep track of the path, we will use a stack. We keep on running our DFS until the destination vertex is not found. As soon as we reach the destination vertex, we terminate our DFS and print the path through the stack that we have maintained. The next application is to check if a given graph is bipartite or not. Bipartite graph is a graph whose vertex can be divided into two sets such that there is no edge between two vertex of the same set. In other words, we can understand it as if we color vertex of first set as blue and the second as green, then no edge should connect two vertex of the same color, that is blue to blue or green to green. To implement it, we use a coloring scheme. We choose a starting vertex and color it with first color. Then we run depth first search for others, keeping in mind two conditions. Firstly, for each new vertex, we color it opposite to its parent color. Secondly, for each edge, we check that it is not connecting two vertices with same color. The final application that we discuss here is quite a general one. It is puzzle solving problem, which is quite common in interview questions and competitive programming. We generally are given with a matrix and certain conditions or obstacles, and we have to traverse within it. These type of puzzles are also solved using depth first search by modifying it to meet the required conditions. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. If you have any doubt or requests, please put it in the comments below. Thanks for watching.